Good morning, Real Life Church. We are so excited that you're watching from wherever you are today. We've got an awesome service coming up that Angie will tell you more about.
Yeah, we are in the last Sunday of our Rock Revival series. And you know what? You still have time today to take your next step to come from watching online to joining us in person, because we are doing all music today. That's right. We are doing 9 songs today. So if you're ready, we're ready, and we can't wait to see you. Next week, Joel's starting his Get in the Game series, and it is football themed. We're having a block party, a tailgate type thing. So make sure you come out and join us next Sunday. We'll get started here in just a minute, guys.
Yeah.
Good morning. Welcome to Real Life Church. My name is Angie. I'm your host today, and we are so excited that you've chosen to spend part of your weekend with us. We're in the last Sunday of our Rock Revival series, and so you guys are in for an awesome special treat today. I wanted to let you know we do have awesome kids programming happening all throughout our service today. We have 6 weeks through preschool back here behind us. This is also where the restrooms are if you need those. If you have elementary students, kindergarten through fifth grade, they're over in the gym under that huge Kid Life sign on the other side of the parking lot. So if you haven't already, go ahead, grab your seats, and we will kick things off here in just a minute.
Mama, I've been fearful for my life from the long arm of the law. Lawman is putting an end to my running, and I'm so far from my home. Whoa, mama, I can hear you crying. You're so scared and all alone. Hangman is coming down from the gallows, and I won't have very long.
Yeah. Y'all sing this with us.
Church, how many jukebox heroes we have out there? You can be seated. How many of you don't know what a jukebox is? There was these things, and they had them in Pizza Hut a lot, and you played music from them, and they were really cool. It was before all we did was listen to headphones and our phones. So welcome to Real Life Church. I'm so glad you decided to spend part of your weekend with us. I'm Joel, and this is Angie.
Hi.
And so, yes, you did just hear two classic rock songs in church. If this is your first time here, listen, we believe that we can have fun when we rejoice in the Lord, and that praising God can even just be having fun with each other. And so we're closing out a series today that is called Rock Revival, and we've been confronting religion, the spirit of religion, through this whole series. And so that's kind of why we're doing the rock songs, because we were kind of trying to create that tension, that moment, so that every single one of us could come face to face with that spirit of religion and go, okay, should I feel the way I feel right now? And maybe some of you need to feel different ways about it. But what we want to do is confront religion and say, look, we're here to have a relationship with Jesus Christ. And we're not here to worry about what religion says or what the spirit of religion does to us. And so I'm going to ask you to do something. I need y'all to stand up, and I'm sorry. I want y'all to greet each other. Woo! You know, find somebody that you don't know. That should be really easy. And just shake howdy for a second.
Maybe my mom can help, because she was like, yeah.
All right, y'all can sit again. Watch this video. So I'm going to pick on y'all, because apparently being a UT fan is like being a Redskins fan. So in your face. Now you know how I feel the whole 6 months of football season. But listen, God can do miracles. And something could change. That's what I have to say every year. So let's just, you know, and if you're a Virginia Tech fan, you're probably sitting pretty, I don't know, did Virginia win? Did they?
We didn't get beat by a John
Battle. Was it by a junior team, though? Okay. So, hey, listen, guys, we are so glad you're here. We love you. That is our next series that's coming up next week. We are kicking off this series with our second annual tailgate block party. So I want you to wear your favorite team shirt or favorite jersey, unless it's a UT shirt. That's up to you. And I don't care if it's NFL, it doesn't matter. Just wear your favorite team shirt. And we're going to be talking all about getting in the game. It is my hope that this series is going to be the most effective series that we've done to date that has mobilized our church to serve and to become fully devoted followers of Jesus. And so that's what our hope is for that.
Yeah, and if this is your first time here, you're what we call our VIPs, and you are the most important person in the room, most important people, because I think there's a lot of you new out there today. And all we're asking you to do today for us is fill out the Connect card that's in the seat back in front of you. There's a place for you to tell us who you are, how we can follow up with you, that it was your first time here. And for everyone, there's also a place there for you to let us know how we can pray for you, or if you want to share a God story with us. We love those. We love to share those. And I also want to do something right now. She's going to be really embarrassed. But I want us to give Jennifer back up there a hand, because the job she does on Sunday is super stressful, and she does a fantastic job, especially when the pastor forgets the video is supposed to be first. So good job following the pastor.
So it's Labor Day weekend, which doesn't mean anything anymore because your kids went back to school, 3 weeks ago. But do y'all remember when we didn't go back to school till after Labor Day? What happened to those days? But listen, so, and I brought that up for this. I keep getting told, one of our leaders and pastors here, he was actually serving at a church that had 40,000 in attendance on any given Sunday. That's crazy. And they saw God move in incredible, powerful ways. And he keeps telling me, hey, man, July 4th weekend, it was really great that we had 140 people. And then it's like, hey, man, for the last weekend before school started, it's really good that we had. And I'm going, but we gotta pack this place out. So next Sunday, September 8th, Labor Day's out of the way, 4th of July's out of the way, school's out of the way. We're having a block party here. We're going to have a satellite trailer watching the games. We're going to have a gigantic grill cooking hot dogs. Bring somebody with you. Get in the game before we even start that series by inviting someone, just one or two people, and get them here. We're going to have incredible chili. At least I hear it's good chili. And we're going to do 20 pounds of it this time, so we have enough. But guys, just if you'll bring one person with you, it'll be awesome. And if you bring 10 people with you, I don't know, we'll give you something. You want that speaker? Bring 10 people. You're going to have one of these speakers if you can get it out of here and in your car, okay? That's the stipulation. We're not moving it. Listen, we love you. We're glad you're here. If you guys want to stand and worship with us.
All right, guys, we're going to move into worship, and we'd like to invite you to come and join us up here at the front if you feel comfortable. If not, that's okay, too. I also want to let you know we're about to do 7 songs pretty much back to back. So if you need to sit at any point, please do so. We want you to know you're in a safe place to worship how you feel led. So let's get this party started.
We will not forget.
ready to sing to our battle cry this morning? Yeah. All right, Real Life Church, you can sit down again for a minute. Woo! Are y'all tired yet? Daggone, y'all sound good this morning. I don't know, maybe y'all got in bed early last night. Maybe you ate your Wheaties. I don't know what happened, but man, y'all sound awesome. So in the next couple of minutes, we're gonna transition into a time of generosity. And guys, this is a time where we practice one of our core values, which is generosity, because we believe you can't what? You can't outgive God. And I mean, that is a true statement in all things. Just try and outgive God. Just try one time. And if you're doing it to trust God, man, He is going to build your faith. And so I'm going to ask you guys, if you would, because we've been confusing everybody, if you would stay seated until the ushers get all the way through, it would be a lot easier for them. And you do. And if this is your first time here, especially if this is your first time here, we don't want any money from you. If you feel compelled to give, by all means, follow the prompting of the Holy Spirit. But we want more for you than we want from you. So what we would like from a first-time guest is that card, the Connect card, with a little bit of information about you. But how can we pray for you? All of us, we come in here on Sunday mornings with a smile on our face, but yet our lives sometimes are falling apart. And you know what? Some of you would say, Joel, my life's not falling apart. It's good right now. Well, that's awesome. But there's other people sitting around you that it's either falling apart, getting ready to, or they just came out of it and got put back together. And so we don't want anything from you as a first-time guest. If you're not a first-time guest, just because you touch the bucket doesn't mean money's going to jump out of your wallet. If you'll just take it from the usher and pass it down the aisle, don't reject it. It's not going to get on you. You don't have to worry about it. Just take it. And we're not going to judge you. We don't care. And some people, like me and my wife, we give online. So you're going to be like, man, that pastor don't even give. Well, we do. We give online. So you have those kinds of opportunities. You can give on our website at reallifebristol.com. You can download something called the Tithely app. You'll need Angie's help with that, like I did. But I also just figured out how to use my bit emoji. How many of y'all know what a bit emoji is? I sent one for the first time by myself yesterday. It was fun. So technology, I'm really good at coffee cans. So if you're like me, there's a coffee can that's going to come by, and you can give that way online or through the Tithely app. But listen, Angie and I have seen in our own lives firsthand that you can't outgive God. And I know that it seems crazy. People in the world and even Christians go, are you crazy? You actually think I should give a portion of my income to a church? Are you nuts? Yeah, I believe that. Yeah, I am a little bit crazy. But is it any crazier spending $30,000 on DirecTV over a course of 16 years? Because I did. I was giving to the church and I spent $30,000 on DirecTV. And a lot of you know that story, and you know what a struggle it was for me to give up something that I believe was truly crazy. And so if Netflix gets as expensive as DirecTV, it's gone. Because I was paying $170 a month for that stuff. So I don't think giving to a church is any crazier than anything else. But here's what I do know. We're making kingdom investments. We're making the kind of investments that are going to last. And we're making the kind of investment that one day we're going to hear, as we become fully devoted followers of Christ, we're going to hear from God Himself, well done, good and faithful servant. And so some of y'all, before Get In The Game even starts, get in the game, take your next step, and give for the first time and trust God for it. And you can do that during this next song. And then once the next song is done, or once the ushers are through, you can stand up if you want and do whatever you want. So here we go. Thank you. So Real Life Church, we have gathered here this morning to declare the goodness and the greatness of our God. Can I get a shout or something? We have gathered here this morning to declare the greatness and the goodness of our God. And let me tell you something. We are joining in with all of heaven. Now, I don't know what your view of what heaven's going to be like when you're there, but I'm pretty sure none of us are going to be sitting on a cloud with a halo playing a harp. But I do know that we will be joining in an ongoing, never-ending worship service of the Most High God. In Revelation, the Bible tells us that there are thousands of angels singing, "Holy, holy, holy is the Lord God Almighty, who was, who is, and who is still to come." And they just repeat it over and over. And you know why they repeat it over and over? Because there's nothing else to say. I mean, that just, as a songwriter, you're always looking for some way to say things, and man, there's just no, you don't need to say anything else. And so what we're doing this morning is preparation for what we're going to be doing in heaven. Amen? So we're getting ready for what God's going to do. And not only are we joining in with heaven, that has been an ongoing worship service from age to age and glory to glory, we are also joining in on a 2,000 Well, thousands of years of worship by God's people right here on this planet. So we're joining in with with a custom that has been going on for thousands of years. And over 2,000 years ago, a guy named King David gathered an assembly together much like this one. I think David was a little bit better looking than me. I know he was in better shape because he was a warrior. I'm a black ops warrior, if you know what that is, and I'm not very good at it. But he gathered together an assembly, and this is what he declared before the assembly. Well, actually, I'm sorry. I'm gonna go back here in a second. Here's what Psalms 145 tells us. It says that one generation will declare the works to the next generation and proclaim your mighty acts. And then a little over 2,000 years ago, David gathered this assembly together, and in 1 Chronicles, here's what he says. And I'm going to mess this up just a little bit, but you're going to get the gist of it. To you, O Lord, is the glory and the goodness and the splendor and the majesty and the power. And he says, all things in heaven and on earth belong to you, God. And you, O God, are exalted high above all of us. And here's how the psalmist said it in Psalms 97. He says, the Lord reigns, let the earth be glad. Let distant shores rejoice, because clouds of thick darkness surround him. Righteousness and justice, they are the foundation of his throne. It says fire goes before him on every side and consumes his foes on every side. His lightning lights up the world. His earth will see and tremble as the mountains melt like wax before the Lord. And before the Lord of all the earth, the heavens tremble. The earth trembles, the mountains melt like wax. He says that all people will see his glory. Do you want to see his glory this morning, Real Life Church? I want to see his glory. We are being able to join in praising the God who crossed time and eternity to have a relationship with you and me. And I am so grateful that he did that for me. And that's why we're worshiping this morning. We're going to night of worship on a Sunday morning. How crazy is that? We want to lift up the mighty name of God. And I pray that you will just sing this with us right now. Nothing shall be impossible. Let's go. I'll be your will.
tears in that grave.
And for every fear, there's an empty grave. For the risen one has overcome. We will not be moved when the earth gives way. For the risen one has overcome. And for every fear, there's an empty grave.
Bless you come, leave me
everybody needed to know you are not forsaken. So we're going to go back into that bridge and we're going to sing, not for a minute was I forsaken. The Lord is in this place. I feel Him here today. Do you feel the presence of God today? He's here because we're here together. He tells us where two or more are gathered in my name, I will be there also. But I want you to also know when you leave here today, He goes with you. If you are in Christ, the Holy Spirit lives in you. Joel said it many times, and one of my dear friends puts it this way. The same power of the Holy Spirit that raised Jesus from the dead, if you are in Christ, that same power is in you, friend. The same power of the Holy Spirit that was on Paul as he was building the church after Jesus' burial, resurrection, and went back to heaven is the same Spirit that's in you, Lauren. Right? The same Holy Spirit, the same power of the Holy Spirit that was on Billy Graham, it's no different, my friends. If you're in Christ, that is the same Holy Spirit in you. Not for a minute are you forsaken. The Lord is in this place because He is in us.
Not for a minute was I forsaken.
The Lord is in this place. The Lord is in this place.
Come Holy Spirit, drop on.
Shit, we got one song left. Man, I tell you what, I'm a good old Baptist boy, but I don't want to leave this place. And I mean, I'm hungry and all, but I'm telling you, man, something powerful today. I love it when we just worship the Holy, worship through the Holy Spirit and Spirit and truth. At the end of this song, at the end of this service, I want you to know that I will be down here. Ed'll probably be able to stick around for a few minutes. When this song is over, we'll be down here to pray with anybody. I don't care if it's salvation, maybe it's the first, you need to meet Jesus and you come face to face with that this morning. Maybe you have something like Angie had dealt with for 17 or 15 years. Maybe it's something with one of your kids. Maybe it's something with your spouse. We want to pray with you because we believe in the power of prayer. We believe that there is nothing that we can't come to our Heavenly Father for and He wouldn't do, because this guy crossed time and eternity for me and you. So there's nothing that we can't lay at the feet of Jesus. And so this morning, there's nothing special about my prayer or even Ed's prayer, as awesome as he is. And James is one of our prayer warriors. We will be down here and we will pray with you at the end of this song if you want to. And I hope somebody out there needs it, I know. Nobody will be paying attention because they're going to try and get out of here to get to the buffet or whatever. So don't worry about people. Oh, wow, what's he going to pray for? What's she going down there for? So this last song is a song that we wrote for you guys. I felt like there was such a spirit of oppression and bondage and depression over our church. And God, I felt like just gave the lyrics to this song as just an encouragement and a testimony to you. And I know a lot of you know it, and I want you to sing it with me.
When I can't take anymore of this, and my heart breaks from loneliness, you surround me with your sweet grace, and I'm reminded you never change.
I don't know what kind of hopeless situation that some of you might be in. I don't don't know what kind of attack from the enemy you might be under, but I want to encourage you this morning that the God who crossed time and eternity to have a relationship with you is saying to you, hold on, I've got this. You don't have to worry. Here's what I've learned after 20 years of ministry, that the greatness of God, it's not found on the mountaintops of success. It is forged in the very pits of despair. Out of the pits of despair, when the greatness of God is being formed in you, then you will rise. And the promises of God, they're not found in the accomplishments of the proud, but the promises of God are found in every failed attempt of the brokenhearted. I'm going to say that again. The promises of God are found in every failed. How many of you have failed this morning, right? Every failed attempt. How many of you started that business and it just didn't go? How many of you had that marriage and it just didn't work? Whatever it is, every failed attempt of the brokenhearted is where the promises of God are found. The Psalms tells us that God is close to the brokenhearted. And Scripture tells us later on that the weeping will be turned to joy. I want to encourage you this morning that whatever it is, it can be turned around. The Bible tells us that God takes what the enemy meant for bad and he turns it around for good, because we believe in this God. And here's what I know about us. We were destined for greatness, but we were distracted by brokenness. We found purpose in possessions that left us hopeless with obsession for more things. More money, more fame, more of all these things that we can't tame in our lives. But there is a hope in what we can't trace. There is a penalty that was paid, a debt now erased. Oh, this light of love takes faith, because you and me, we were set apart by design, and we are restored by grace. Our brokenness becomes His glory, our hopelessness replaced by His story. You may be ignored by the world, but I'm here to tell you, you are recognized by God, for He knits you together in your mother's womb. You are marvelously and wonderfully made. He says, I know the plans I have for you, plans to prosper you and not to harm you, to give you a hope and to give you a future. This is the God that we are here to declare the glory and the goodness of. This is the God that every time I failed, every time I felt like I was at the bottom and I would never rise from the ashes, God would say, get back up, son. If you're not dead, I'm not done with you. And some of you, you've been down. You might be down right now. I don't know what it is. But God's saying, get up, son. Get up, daughter. You're not down. You're not dead. You're not broken yet. Get back up. He tells us that no weapon formed against us shall prosper. And if this God is for us, then who the heck can be against us? Notice that that song, it says, when the earth gives way, we will not be moved. Some of us think that if we get in Christ, that the earth will never give way, that there's never going to be doubt, that there's never going to be trouble. But that song says, hey, there's going to be trouble, but it is God, not the ground, that holds you up. He is holding you in His mighty hand, and nothing can separate you from the love of God. I don't care if you had an abortion. I don't care if you've been divorced 50 times. I don't care if you killed somebody. You can't be separated from the love of God if you are in Christ Jesus. The world beats us down. I've been called a false teacher over the past few days because I preach the love of Jesus Christ, and I preach that there is sin. Without sin, we wouldn't need grace. So we've got this grace that God is offering to us. But nothing can separate us from the love of God. And we've got to love those who hate us. I talked about it last week. I read the passage of Scripture that says, love those who hate you. Do something good for those who persecute you. Guys, let's be the church. We're not always going to agree. We're not always going to have, you know, we're not always going to be right on with each other. But we can love one another. We can fight for that unity. And let's sing this again. See you next week.
Listen to faith, I won't listen to fear, and you can say what you want, 'cause I just